Phelps, Bukowski. Beat cop says he located a green Kaiser Frazier from the hot sheet. Address is 6 West 2nd Street. Get over there and see what you can find out. Go on. Sorry to inconvenience you.
We're on it, Captain.
Ooh, what's going on, guys? I'm Jake, the offensive gamer, and this is LA Noire Part 5.
The longer the hot sheet gets.
It pays the rent, though. Keeps Mrs. Phelps in the manner to which she's accustomed.
Get on away, dickhead.
I'm not sure she'd agree with you.
Passionate romantic type like you, Cole? I don't believe a word of it.
Yeah, the bum took a swipe.
You know what? Actually, I'm not so sure I'm a big fan of this outfit anymore. I think I'm going to switch it. I got a couple of downloadable ones, so I'm going to try one of those out. Let's see. I could just go with... Nah, Sword of Justice is too dark for this area. I don't know. Part of me wants to go with the Broderick. It's too flashy, though. Let's try... The sharpshooter looks like shit, but let's just try it out.
Do you really think I'm gonna steal? It's been a year. What's he waiting for?
All right.
Find the goddamn exit.
Let's go. Come on. Dick. It's your fucking problem.
They're calling her the doll, you know. Wonder what Veronica Lake makes of that one.
What a case. You hear whether they're making any progress?
Well, Captain Donnelly seems to think they have it all wrapped up. Brown and Green are sweating this manly character. I heard it'll be in front of a grand jury by next week.
Of course. Terrible enough being murdered like that without having your death. Strewn all over the front.
Clearly that's in reference to the Black Dahlia murders, and this is about the time frame that that would have happened. It's the 40s and all that in L.A. Anybody who's not aware of the Black Dahlia murder, go ahead and just look it up. I really don't have enough, you know, time in between all this stuff. There's too much dialogue to be able to fully explain the case and what happened. But let's just say I won't need to so much if you keep watching. I don't feel like that's too spoilery.
That's the car, Cole. Just pulling out of the drive. Get him.
Uh-oh.
Remember, we need him healthy enough to answer questions.
All right, so don't kill him.
1247, Detective Phelps, requesting immediate backup in pursuit of a stolen green Kaiser Frazier from 6 West 2nd Street.
Do we have road spikes? Is that a thing in the 40s? I'm sure that could have been, you know, could have come in handy at some point.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on.
Come on, dickhead. Come on now. What do you think this is?
Enough games, Phelps. Take this guy out.
I'm trying. Now stop.
All right, all right. Maybe I was a couple miles over the speed limit.
Get bracelets
out of the car now.
I'll call it in.
Why did you run from us?
I saw a big car in my rearview mirror with two tough guys bearing down on me. What would you do?
What's your name?
Cliff Harrison.
You're under arrest.
For what? What are you talking about?
Nice try. I'm talking about the car being stolen.
You're out of your mind. I bought the car, and I've got the paperwork to prove it.
Name is Cliff Harrison.
Looks like we'll have some questions for the people at Coombs Automotive.
Paid $2,400 for it. All right. I don't remember this case as well. It's another DLC case, so I might make some mistakes on it just because I've only played this once before, and that was a couple years ago, so yeah.
You purchased this car from Coombs Automotive Company?
Yeah, that's right.
And the ownership papers?
From the same place.
If this is a forgery, it's top-notch. This will need to be traced.
Can I flip it? There we go. All right. Checks out.
You have a criminal record, Mr. Harrison?
No, nothing like that.
I'm doubting it, but I'm just in case. Let's see. Oh, yeah. Bullshit.
You better give us something, Cliff, or we're gonna make this hard on you.
I didn't steal the car. I ran because... I've got some wacky-backy in the glove compartment.
How much, Cliff?
One reefer.
One reefer.
We'll let it slide. You're in enough trouble. Who did you deal with at Coombs Automotive?
The owner, Richard Coombs.
And he made out the bill of sale, personally?
Of course he did. He kept a facsimile for his records. Check with him.
We're going to get to the bottom of this, Harrison. Until we do, you're going downtown.
You gotta be kidding me! I'm getting arrested for buying a goddamn car?
If everything is legit, Harrison, you'll be out soon. Until then, if I were you, I'd keep my mouth shut.
Bag his possessions as evidence, and have him arraigned for Grand Theft Auto.
Right, Detective.
You know who my father is!
We need to get to Coombs Auto and check out Harrison's story.
I don't know, this suit's starting to grow on me a little bit. I know the coloring doesn't really match very well together, that disgusting yellow.
I think he's telling the truth.
Some of the most convincing people you will ever listen to are born liars. Usually they're called politicians.
Ho ho. I ran that guy off the road. But yeah, that yellow that he's wearing under the jacket, I don't know exactly what type of yellow it is, but it's disgusting.
He seemed like a clean-cut kid.
Well, I get it. You see some kid who's basically you 5 years ago and assume he's got to be innocent.
I'm more than happy to be proved wrong.
Hey, if he'd been black or Hispanic, you'd be singing a different tune. You spout all this communist crap about treating everybody the same, but it only works one way.
I'm not sure that's communism.
Oh, God, please. Not another history lesson from the man who single-handedly won the war.
Yeah, you and your knowledge.
Yes, I feel much better. We'll shake down the car dealer and take it from there. Unless his daddy plays golf with yours, of course. In which case, we'll give him a firm gentleman's handshake and be on our way.
See? I knew you weren't finished.
Yeah, Cole and his knowledge and reasoning. What an asshole.
Not another step. I have got a Buick Century sedan that would be absolutely perfect for you.
Detective Phelps, LAPD, are you the owner?
That's right. Richard Coombs at your service. You looking to trade in a black and white, boys?
Mr. Coombs, we're investigating an auto theft. A man by the name of Cliff Harrison claims he bought the car here.
Well, some people would say that my cars are a steal. That's a joke, son.
Very amusing, Mr. Coombs.
I remember Harrison. It was a green two-tone Kaiser Fraser, if I remember rightly.
Do you have the bill of sale?
It's in my office. Walk this way.
Are you fucking...
That's a joke too, son.
Phelps, you mind if I shoot this guy? He's getting on my nerves.
Is this guy like fucking Willy Wonka or something? What's wrong with you? I might shoot this fucker.
Here it is. Got the original pink slip there, too.
Give me that shit.
Gene Archer. 146 North Fremont Avenue.
Alright, I'll take a look at the other thing, whatever the hell that is. Is that a receipt or an envelope? Yeah, no, a receipt. Cliff Harrison.
Harrison's purchase receipt was legit, at least.
The fuck?
We have a couple of questions.
Alright, fellas. Shoot.
Excuse me. Let's see. Details, sure.
Can you tell us how you came to buy the car?
Girl just wandered in right off the street.
Yeah.
Nothing unusual about the car?
Not really my usual type of vehicle. The price was certainly right, though. Nice girl, but about as sharp as a bag of wet mice.
Did you pay with check or cash?
A check. She wanted it made out to cash, but I insisted. Man has to watch his cash flow.
What name?
I made it out to Gene Archer on the Bank of Arcadia.
Nice memory.
Can you describe this Gene Archer?
Brunette, maybe 25, 26. A little on the plump side, but not bone ugly.
Yeah.
What was your impression of her?
Kind of harried and harassed.
Yeah, she's hairy.
To go somewhere, oh. But no place to go. You get to know the type.
You see, I thought...
When exactly did you hand over the check, Mr. Combs?
Close of play on Friday.
You see, this is another one of those situations where had he just said something and then he just stared at me blankly, I would have bought it, but I'm going to go down on this one.
Why didn't you pay her cash? You knew the car was dirty.
I had an inkling. When people are in a hurry for money, always pay by check, son. Gives you a couple days to back out.
Hmm.
Do you know anything about the company that prints these pink slips?
Nope. Should I? It isn't exactly my business.
Says Marquee Printing. You've never heard of them?
Marquee. Sure. They do all the government red tape. You'll find the place down on Aliso Street near San Pedro.
This was all above board.
Yes. Of course it was.
Well, we kind of already know that that's not the case, so...
Did this look legitimate to you, Coombs?
I'm in used cars, son. Not bearer bonds. In my business, you don't look a gift horse in the mouth. Now don't come on all high and mighty with me if you want my help.
Thanks for your help, Mr. Coombs. We need to continue the investigation.
Hope you sort out your problem with Mr. Harrison. Go easy on him, son. Boy's about as sharp as a bowling ball. He's built too low. The fastballs fly over his head.
Let me shoot this guy, please. You have a pleasant day, Mr. Coombs.
It's a cliche slinging bucket of jizz. You know what? Just for that, I'm
Harrison
taking your fucking car.
Hook, but we can still run an APB on that Gene Archer. Get on the horn and call it in.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Let's go with 146. I need to call. I didn't realize. That's probably why he told me to call it in.
Are you drunk, mister? Or are you just cracked?
Why? Because I jumped over something?
Phelps badge 1247.
How can I help, detective?
Requesting an APB on Gene Archer, age approximately 25, on suspicion of Grand Theft Auto.
I'll relay the information.
Messages, please.
A James Belasco is being held at Central Station on suspicion of GTA. Possible link to the Harrison case. They're waiting on you to conduct the interview.
Thanks for your help.
Well, I think Belasco can wait. I'm going to go check out the what was it, 146 something Fremont? I want to make sure that I still have it marked. Yeah.
I like your thinking, Phelps. Call it evidence. The guy's an asshole. He can pick it up at the pound.
Sure. Let's go with that.
Here's a chicken and egg question for you. Do you think you have to be an asshole to sell cars? Or that selling cars turns you into an asshole?
You've got it in for everyone today, haven't you?
I've always got it in for car sales. Doesn't matter what day it is.
Just like me.
Why do they always think they're comedians when they're about as funny as a heart attack?
Maybe the more annoying they are, the quicker you...
I don't know, I gotta say, heart attacks can be pretty funny. Like, I mean, you know, if it happens to an old lady or something like that.
...on the dotted line, just to get the hell out of there.
There was this one time I saw this old lady have a heart attack, and so I laughed at her, and everybody looked at me like I was, like, an asshole or something, and I don't really understand why. You know, I mean, I thought it was pretty funny, but everybody was just horrified. Somebody called me a monster or something. I don't get it.
Empty. Should have known that Archer broad would have given us a false address.
She didn't give you the address.
We should go to the station.
Give somebody else.
Glasgow guy has to say.
Somebody else that was given the address, they gave it to you. Yeah, police station it is. The reason why I'm choosing police station first is primarily because of, what was his name? Bukowski saying so. I've noticed, in the past when I play this game, whenever, like, your partner kind of gives you hints, he kind of will sometimes give you hints as to where you should go next for continuity purposes. So I usually adhere to that. On occasion, I'll decide not to. Whoa-ho-ho. Wow, that was disgusting.
Detectives, Belasco is prepped and ready in two. Another stolen car with legit papers.
Thanks.
Why do they always give me interview room two? Like, is one just always taken up? And why do I get two? Why doesn't somebody else get two? Is this like discrimination or some shit? The fuck?
Crummy bastard.
Excuse
James
me.
Belasco?
I want a lawyer. It's my car, and I got the proof right here. Take a look for yourself.
I understand you, but thousands wouldn't.
The paper is real enough, Belasco, but the car isn't yours. This pink slip is a forgery.
Yeah, so you're the crummy bastard now.
Where were you taking the car, James?
Blow it off, greenhorn. You'll get nothing from me.
Fuck you.
You're a two-time loser. If you don't give me something, I'm gonna ask the DA for the maximum. You're looking at 10 years, Belasco. Kiss your youth goodbye.
I want a deal.
Keep talking and we'll see what sort of deal you're worth.
My job is to drive the cars out of state. Nevada, Arizona, sometimes New Mexico. With the paperwork they provide, it's normally a breeze.
Does the name Jean Archer mean anything to you?
Nope. Never heard of her.
Okay, so see, I already know he's full of shit, but I don't know. I've gathered a decent amount of information at this point. Oh, yeah, duh.
You're a liar, James.
Say that again. I'm telling the truth. I don't know the broad.
The ownership papers would dictate otherwise.
So that's why you both have the same address printed on your pink slips. She's a mule for these stolen vehicles, genius. Same as you.
Jesus. All right, I know her. Stupidest broad I ever met. Always cooking up crazy schemes. I don't know why those guys use her. You happy now?
What happens to the cars once they cross over the state lines?
I don't know. I just deliver them.
Yeah, so far, prior, questions would dictate he's full of shit, so, and plus his eyes are wandering, but I don't think there's any evidence. Yeah, I can't really prove that he's lying, but yeah, doubt. Yep, see, there you go.
Something, Belasco, or I'll take you back to the cells and tell the whole station you're a child molester. How long do you think you'll last?
Okay, I hear you. Cars get sold in Chicago or back east. Sometimes I bring back cars coming the other way.
Where do you pick up the cars, Belasco?
Warehouses. Mainly in east downtown.
He's doing the same thing, you know? Fuck it, let's go 444.
An address, Belasco. You want my help with the DA? Cough it up, now.
A place on Industrial Street. I don't know the number. You're gonna help me out, right?
Keep talking, kid, and we'll see what we can do.
All right, James. We're gonna check if this information is worth anything.
And if it is, I need your help here, pal.
If it is, then we'll know you're a man of your word, and so will the DA.
You're Phelps, right?
Yes, I am. Look, can we do this later? I'm in the middle of it.
Ray Pinker. I'm with Technical Services. The pink slips are all real.
Yes, we know that.
There's only one company that prints them in California, the Marquee Printing Company. They've confirmed that the numbers are legitimate.
You've checked them out?
Sure. They're on Aliso Street near the corner of San Pedro. The guy I spoke to was Lightfall. Gordon Lightfall. Here, I wrote it down.
Thanks, Ray.
So that guy's Ray Pinker.
We'll get down there as soon as we can.
I thought that it was the guy that works at the morgue. What the fuck is his name then? All right, well, regardless. Thanks a lot, I guess.
Phelps, your GTA suspect, Gene Archer, spotted by a patrolman. Western Union office, 253 South Hill. Less than a minute away down the street if you run. Go! She won't hang around.
That's right, I forgot about that. Yeah, I gotta get down there quick. I think I have he said like a minute. I think there's like 30, 45 seconds that I have to run all the way down there. Why didn't I just drive? God, I feel like an asshole now.
LAPD. We'll take it from here.
God damn it. Everyone's against me.
What's up, fatty?
Look, just let me get my money and get out of here, okay? You look sweet. How about giving a girl a break? I could be very nice.
I'm afraid I can't do that, Miss Archer. Stefan, call for a black and white.
Just my luck to get the only hair sure cop in the LAPD.
The car you sold to Coombs was stolen, Miss Archer. There won't be any money.
I handed over all the right paperwork when I sold it, Buster.
Ugh. Fuck you.
Gene, you've blown open the whole operation because you were dumb enough to try to sell one of the cars. What do you think
Buster.
They're going to do to you? Give me something.
I was just doing what they do. They pay me $50 to drive the car. I made $2,000 selling it.
You made zero. And if they catch you, you're dead. Is that all your life's worth?
Look, a girl needs things. I don't see you looking out for me.
But, like, tampons? Like, what do girls need in comparison to other people? I don't understand.
How long have you and Belasco been delivering cars?
Who is James Belasco?
Yeah, no, complete bullshit.
You're lying. James Belasco. I don't remember mentioning his first name, Miss Archer.
Oh, I think you did, didn't you?
You must be kind of stupid.
Well, I'm sure of it. Anyway, I don't know him.
Yeah, and the ownership papers. Yeah, exactly.
You aren't sharp enough to lie to me, Gene. You and James Belasco share the same address on your pink slips. We have him in a cell.
Okay, so I know the creep. The pink slips are real. The home addresses are always vacant lots. Bigelow is always boasting that the paperwork is legit and that if we stick to our stories...
And don't try and sell the car?
Yeah, that too.
I really like Bukowski.
Tell me where you picked up the car, Miss Archer.
Look, I can't remember. Let me go, will you? Please. What have I got to do?
You got to suck my dick. Not really, I'm just... See, and she wants to do it too. You can see the mouth movements. No thank you, lady.
Here, Gene. I'll have the reporters down here and have your picture in all the papers. You'll have nowhere to run.
All right, already. I get the message. I pick up the cars from a guy named Bigelow. 58 Industrial Street. Big warehouse, full of goons. Now you've got what you want. Can I go? Please?
No, you sure can. We've got a car waiting outside for you.
You're arrested.
Career advice, Gene. Get out of crime. Marry someone boring who has money and will find you captivating.
Is this guy for real?
He takes a little getting used to, but yeah, he generally means what he says.
She's really dumb. Do I use the game well? No? Alright then. What are the places I can go to now? I think one of them was like an industrial... Yeah. We'll save Marquee for last. unless there's something after that. But it, judging by how long this has been so far, I'm pretty sure these are the last two.
Used to getting her own way.
Shit!
Can we try to get there in one piece?
I'm sorry. I am so sorry.
Little did she know her feminine charms were useless against the impenetrable Cole Phelps.
That's suggestive.
And what is your type, Phelps?
I'm married.
Not fat.
I know that. But you're not blind or dead inside, are you? Wait. Scrap that second half of the question.
I don't know. Blondes, I guess.
Hallelujah! The man is here! Slow down! Hallelujah! The man is human after all. Now we're getting some. Yep, I'm with you on the blondes. Brunettes are fine too. And there's nothing wrong with a good redhead. But I draw the line at gray.
You know, old people.
I might have to lift that. Watch it!
Man with high standards.
The standards are only as high as the last glass of whiskey.
Ah, shit, he gets drunk and then fucks bitches. You hear that? I'm sorry, I'm being a really obnoxious asshole right now. I gotta knock that off. Yeah.
I thought you Marines were gung-ho, Cole. You have a 45, don't you ever want to use it? I'll take the back. Just give me a few seconds to get around there.
Cole Phelps, LAPD. All of you are coming downtown with me.
Yep. Nope. Seems as though they don't agree with that.
Throw out the gun.
Jesus Christ. Huh. That was kind of a weak-ass explosion, but that's fine. This game was made in 2011, sort of. They use gunfights in this game rather sparingly, and I actually kind of appreciate that. Like, this isn't a full-on action game. The primary focus of this title is supposed to be being a detective, you know, piecing stories together and, you know, being a cop. Oh, I didn't realize I could do blind fire. That's pretty cool. Oh shit. Nice job, Bukowski.
Really hurts.
Yeah, no fucking kidding. There's a piece of metal inside of you. Of course it hurts.
Let's clear the top floor.
Oh, there's another guy.
I'm gonna get drilled in the back on the way out.
Bukowski, you are a dumb shit. I hope you know that. This was really ill-advised, and you probably should not be a police officer. Oh, fuck yeah. I actually don't like the shotguns as much as the pistols. I feel like less of a cop and more like a gang member. But that's fine. I can shoot my shotgun better than you. Dick shot!
I'm gonna stay down.
Ooh. Blood splatter all over. Again.
I heard something.
Why? Why not? You know? There's no ammo.
Damn thing's no good to me.
Oh, yeah, maybe there is. Never mind. I did not realize that. Wow, your innards are just all over that wall right now.
All right, don't shoot! Keep your hands up. Watch him, Bukowski. He doesn't move until I've tossed this place.
Ha Gordon Lightball.
Marquee Printing Company. There's nothing like going direct to the source.
All right, so that is our next course of action.
A betting slip. Looks like Mr. Lightball has been on a losing streak.
All right. Anything else? You can just hang on one more second. What's this?
There are enough slips here to keep them stealing cars till Christmas.
That book looks interesting.
We got a trail of pink slips and stolen cars that leads right to your door, Bigelow. You're in this up to your neck, but I don't think you're the man in charge. Make it easier on yourself. Give him up.
I had to work on cars for customers. You charge in here shooting up the place like it's the Ballad of Bulge. I can't give you anything.
He said bulge.
We know about Marquee Printing. You can make this easier on yourself by giving us your man on the inside.
I sometimes repair cars and put them back on the road. I need a pink slip to resell them. There's no problem there.
You look like a clown. Like, he looks like a fucking clown.
There are at least 4 dead men in this warehouse. A couple more. Punks won't make for that much extra paperwork. We'd be doing the legal system a favor.
Okay, tough guy. I get the message. Lightfall. The guy who runs Marquee. He's the big shot. He likes to spend big at the track. He owes people.
He has a really nice accent. Do you hear that?
Lightfall. The guy with no luck at the track. Tell me about him.
It's one of the guys lying over there.
Okay, now I know that's bullshit.
He has no luck.
That's absolutely bullshit, but I don't know whether to doubt or lie, so I'm going to use intuition. And, of course, fucking damn it. Alright, wow. Oh, that's really cool. They kind of just, like, scratch him out like that. Oh, yeah, the delivery note. Stupid.
That's the best lie you can come up with, Bigelow.
Hey, would I lie to you, detective? I'm not exactly in a good position here now, am I?
Well, hold on. What was that? No. Yeah, no, signed off.
Gordon Lightball owns Marquee Printing, a government print shop. He's losing big at the track.
He has these big government contracts. He's in hock over 20 grand. If the feds find out, contracts will be all over. Lightball plays ball.
All right, Bigelow. The heat is off you. Play your cards right, and you'll be able to count your time in Quentin on one hand.
Okay, we can go ahead and wrap this up now. Gotta get to the car first, of course. What, you guys see something? What's in here? What's going on? Nothing? Okay. Shut up. What? Now let's go ahead and arrest Gordon Lightfall. Hey, dickhead, I'm a police officer. Did you not hear the siren?
Gonna take some cleaning up, that's for sure.
I wish it hadn't gone that way.
Well, we shouldn't bring guns to work with them. We didn't have a lot of choice.
You have to admire the barefaced cheek of someone who tries to blow your brains out one minute and pleads innocence the next.
Yeah, especially when he's surrounded by evidence. But guys like Bigelow spend so much time convincing themselves that they're not doing anything wrong that they actually start to believe their own bullshit.
They get sloppy. Bigelow, Lightball, all of them. If they hadn't, who knows how long they could have kept this racket going.
Complacency or greed. It's always one of the two that brings them down.
Nah, fuck me.
All units, a 459 just occurred in 6th and Ceres. Any unit to handle, code 2 identified.
Alright then. See, I enjoyed this DLC. It's actually probably my favorite of the two traffic DLCs. This is the only other one for the traffic desk. I don't know, for some reason the console's car just kind of bores me. But this one I enjoy more so for you know, partially because of the gunfire, which, you know, it's fun to have. It's not incredibly well developed in this game, but it's solid, and you know, it's good as a compliment every once in a while. Which is exactly what it should be for a detective game. It shouldn't be the focus, it should be a compliment. Which is what it is. I want to take a look at some stuff. You never know, there might be something to investigate. No? Okay.
You're under arrest.
I'm sorry, just what the hell are you talking about?
We found a box of pink slips in a warehouse full of hot cars. You signed for them, Lightbulb.
I signed for all the orders and deliveries.
No, no.
You'll need something better than that, cowboy.
I have evidence.
Save it, Lightbulb. We already have all we need to send you down.
I've had enough of this. You either produce some shred of proof, or I call my attorney.
Nice acting. But yeah, we got the betting slips. Yeah, exactly.
You're in the hole with the organization. We know about the debts, Lightbulb.
I agree. I have a small problem. I'm prepared to help you in any way I can, Detective. I'll name names. I need you to keep this out of the paper.
You need to shut up now, Lightbulb. Gordon Lightbulb, I'm charging you with conspiracy and fraud. Hands behind your back.
The LAPD Central Traffic Division has today smashed a nationwide auto theft ring, writes crime correspondent, blah, blah, blah. Oh, here it is. Traffic squad detectives confronted a large group of armed thugs. After an exchange of gunfire, more than a dozen dead criminals were removed from the scene. The LAPD sustained no casualties. Damn fine work, Phelps. Now get out there and nail some more bad guys, will you? I want to finish reading this.
My family runs a shipping business in San Francisco. We used to have two ships a week to Tokyo. We've been in shipping for two generations, Hank. I've never been on a voyage anywhere. I feel like Odysseus in the beginning of his journey.
The Odyssey took 10 years, Cole.
This is the American century. America can rule the world after we win this war.
We need to stay alive, Cole. These men are counting on us. Have you heard what the veterans are saying to each other?
No.
Golden Gate in 48. That's four more hard years of fighting.